Once that is done, then you can just insert the cup or whatever the container is into the corresponding hole and get ready to mix the epoxy. As I've noted before, I like to use syringes to mix mine. These are 60cc syringes, and I'm going to make up a what I call a 120, which is 60cc of hardener and 120cc of resin, since this is a 2-to-1 mix. So 60cc of hardener is in the syringe and put in first, and then the 120cc of resin, which will be two syringes, of course. This is also going to be mixed with Cabasil to a thickness of approximately a thick mayonnaise. So we'll start off just by mixing up just the resin, just a little bit, get it started, and then we'll grab hold of some Cabasil. This is a 120. I will use 6 tablespoons of Cabasil, heaping tablespoons of Cabasil for this. In my experience, that gives me what I want in terms of thickness. And we're going to mix it up. I mix my epoxy. If I'm just mixing epoxy and resin, I mix it 250 times, every 10 stirs in alternating direction. Since this is Cabasil and resin and hardener, I'm going to mix it 100 times for each double tablespoonful of Cabasil. This is the first one. That's done. Now we'll add the second double tablespoon fulls of Cabasil. That's one. And here comes the other one. And we'll mix it again for another 100 times. I have to start up kind of slow because the Cabasil flies around quite a bit. But once it starts to get wetted in and mixed in, you can go a little faster. And now for the last two tablespoonfuls of heaping tablespoon, I might add, tablespoonfuls of Cabasil. There's one, and there's two. Now with another 100 mixes, we'll be all set and ready to go. This will give me that thick mayonnaise or very thin peanut butter consistency that I want, because I'm going to be doing some filling of screw heads and gaps and whatever it is, divots and dents. And so that's what I want, that kind of consistency. Then that'll be sanded down, flush, and we'll have a nice permanent fill. And that does it.
That's pretty good.